cortege is now reaching the bottom end of Constitution Hill and coming out in front of Buckingham Palace, and will shortly pass the Queen and the royal family. Bow from the Queen as the coffin passed the west side of Buckingham Palace. The Duchess of York, who was one of her closest friends. Who joined the royal family as she did. Those members of the royal family will now go separately by car to the Abbey. We have not yet, of course, seen the Prince of Wales, or Prince William, or Prince Harry. They weren't there at Buckingham Palace, and it is said they may be joining at some stage the funeral procession itself, but for the moment we do not know. A simple card on the first of those reeds, just saying, you may have been able to read it, Mummy. Someone paying their own tribute, the skirl of the pipes and a Scottish lament sounding out from across the crowd. Otherwise this procession has had no music. Carriage turns now into the grand processional route of the Mall, down which so many processions have passed, down which Princess Diana herself went on her wedding day, cheered by the crowds on either side. and mourners standing thick to left and to right. At St. James's Palace, the Prince of Wales, behind him Prince William, Prince Harry, walking down towards the Mall, so it does look as though they will join in the procession, in the funeral cortege, Charles Spencer, Earl Spencer, on the left of Prince William. He'll be giving the address later on, and the Duke of Edinburgh. Everyone's thoughts must surely be with those two boys, her sons, as they wait for the funeral cortege to make its way down the long open road of the Mall to where they will first see it as it comes into sight by St. James's Palace. This cortege is now halfway along the Mall. And still, as it goes,